Hi, I'm Pete, a developer advocate at Google. We all know that a snappy website is always a great thing. It means happier users and higher conversions. And fast is especially important on mobile, where everybody's always in a hurry. PageSpeed Insights is an awesome tool that you can use to improve the performance of your site. When you profile a page with PageSpeed Insights, it evaluates the page and gives you a score based on performance and user experience, based on a set of criteria and best practices. For a quick, easy analysis, you can just hit the PageSpeed Insights service by clicking the link on screen. But let's give the Web Fundamentals site a try to see how it works. I'll enter a URL and hit the Analyze button. After a few seconds, PageSpeed reports back its findings. On this page, we scored a 70 out of 100 for speed. Not bad, but there's certainly room for improvement here. It gives us a list of criteria that we should fix. On this page, it recommends that we eliminate the render blocking CSS and scripts. In our case, it's our primary CSS file and a CSS file that loads some specialized fonts. It also tells us that we should check the caching headers on some of our files. It looks like a couple of the files are cached for 60 minutes, and we definitely want to up that number. We had 8 rules pass, there are no redirects, and the page weight has been optimized by turning on compression and minifying the JavaScript, HTML, CSS, and images. The above-the-fold content has been properly prioritized, and the servers are responding quickly. Perfect. We're in a good situation. Now, we get a similar report for the user experience rules. It looks like this page was dinged 2 points because some of the tap targets are a little bit too close together. Otherwise, the page is good. It doesn't use any plugins, the viewport is configured properly, and the content is sized to fit, and all the font sizes are large enough to read. This is great as a manual, one-off analysis, but you can go even deeper. You can integrate PageSpeed Insights directly into your development workflow with the PageSpeed Insights API. It uses a simple REST API that takes 3 parameters: the URL that we want to test, the API key that identifies our project, and oh, by the way, that, not really my API key, so don't bother trying it, and the strategy, either desktop or mobile, that you want to test against. You can learn about some of the other optional parameters in the documentation. Now, if you don't already have an API key, you'll need to enable the PageSpeed Insights API in the Google Developer Console, and you can get your key there. The PageSpeed Insights API returns its results as a JSON object. It includes the server response code, the final URL, and the score. It also includes page stats, such as the total number of each resource downloaded, the total number of hosts, and the size of the request. And finally, the results of all the rules tested. Each PageSpeed rule generates an impact number that indicates the importance or priority of implementing that set of suggestions for the rule, relative to the other rules. For instance, if enabling compression would save 1 megabyte, while optimizing images would say 500K, then the enable compression rule would have an impact value that's twice that of the optimize images rule. You can query the URL from the command line, or better yet, just automate it. Grunt makes the command line testing super easy. The Grunt PageSpeed plugin simply tests the deployed pages, reporting the PageSpeed score, page stats, and the individual rule results. If the PageSpeed score falls below the specified threshold, well, then the grunt task fails. By testing your site regularly with a cron job or other scheduled task and saving the results, you can use PageSpeed Insights to track your site over time. Small changes, when looked at individually, may not make a big difference, but over time, these numbers add up, helping you to spot regressions or see trends that you might have otherwise have missed. By adding PageSpeed Insights to your development workflow today, you can ensure that your pages follow the best practices for performance and user experiences, and you can spot trends before they become a problem. So go Test your pages right now, and then add PageSpeed Insights to your workflow. Thanks for watching, and go build something awesome.